Professor, what's the update at the control room?
I'm in, and I think I found the Halo's weapon systems. Once I've deactivated them, then I'll place the comms beacon.
Keep us updated. Jerome, Atriox will be sending everything to stop us. You need to hold the line and protect the professor in the control room until she's finished her work.
Won't let you down, sir.
The clock's ticking, and we don't have time to drop a base and build it up. You're going to have to rely on turret defenses, so keep them up and running.
Fresh troops will be sent in directly from the Spirit of Fire as soon as they're ready to deploy. And I've got all the ship's weapon systems primed and ready, so we'll help as much as we can from up here.
Okay, everyone. Let's get to work. Good luck.
Wait, I'm not gonna have a base? But I'm gonna have to hold the line with turrets? Oh no, make sure you use the Spirit of Fire's full arsenal to support your troops. We won't have access to a fire base. Uh-oh. This is gonna be different.
Red team, you have to hold the Banished back until the professor's done her work.
Don't worry, sir, we've got her. And it looks like we've got company right now.
This control room has a defensive shield, but it won't last long. You just keep the wolves at bay.
Oh, this is a big area to cover. Oh, shit. Oh, no.
The Spirit of Fire's weapons are at your disposal. Get the ship in the fight.
Ooh.
Turrets and restoration drones are online. Call in support when you need it. The Spirit of Fire is standing by to assist, Jerome. Use everything you can. We have to keep the professor safe.
So it looks like we have infinite resources and we can just do whatever the hell we want with these turrets. Nice. All right. All leader powers are currently active and we can use them at any point without any worry about cost. It's all going to be a matter of using them optimally, which I am totally down for.
Where do you want us,
Marines, ready to serve.
There's a massive influx of Banished heading to your position, team.
But from which direction? Because there's so many different directions this could go towards. Oh, well, hey, look at that. We lucked out. They're coming in from the bottom now.
Turret constructed. Turret constructed.
Ready for duty, sir.
Turret constructed.
All right, let's get these units into... Let's get these units into the garrisons.
Constructed.
Yeah! Incinerate them! Hostile ground troops are trying to...
Let's take it!
Ready for orders, sir!
Let's do this!
Lock and load!
Oh my god, look how much shit's coming out here. Okay, time for some turrets! Close air support! That side will be fine. I want to see what happens when we bring in some pelicans.
I'm being hit by enemy troops! I need support ASAP!
Alright, Pelicans! Holy shit, these are decked out. Oh my god!
Leader power ready.
Oh, that's awesome. Okay, we're gonna casually set some stuff up here.
Marines! Take it, squad!
We're gonna need this to be anti-infantry, anti-vehicle... anti-infantry... anti-infantry. Alright. Do we have any Cyclops on standby? Not really. We have vehicles though, or we have Spartans.
Red team, the Banished have warlords on the field overseeing their troops. Eliminating them will disrupt the Banished's chain of command.
Roger, sir.
Nothing like sowing a little chaos.
Upgraded.
Yeah, sure. All right, I can do that. So we have to kill the brute warlords.
We'll be sending in reinforcements directly from the ship just as soon as they're ready to deploy.
Show them how it's done, Helljumpers. We've got our orders. Let's go.
All right, let's bring our Spartans around. I'm gonna go fight those warlords right now. We should be able to take them on with this many forces. Yes! Yes! Here we go! We're gonna establish our Cyclopses in all the garrisons that we can put them in.
Squad. Let's take it, Helljumpers.
Okay. These guys will be...
Too slow,
Cyclops, good to go. On my way.
Assault Group 1. Assault Group 1, let's press out!
Make my way.
Nightingale, you chill out in this area? I wish I could order them to hold a place. I really do. I would like to just tell them, hey, everybody in this area, don't go beyond this place.
Everyone be ready to go. ASAP.
On the move.
Sir, yes, sir.
Alright, let's go clear out some warlords.
On the way.
Okay, we're gonna send our holograms in to really distract the enemies. ODST drops! I feel like close air support will be incredibly invaluable.
ODST's ready! We'll get it done! Count on us!
Leader power ready.
Easy target help!
Warlord down.
Okay, that's a warlord gone. Already. Let's move out. Control group one. I mean, the holograms are gonna disappear at some point, but that's fine.
On the way.
So what we're gonna do is the next time we have like a massive enemy attack, we're gonna soften them up with archer missiles first, because we got level 3 ones. Do we have- how many nightingales we have? We have quite a few. Okay. I'm gonna put this Cyclops on high ground. As well as over here.
We're under attack from enemy vehicles, over!
Things should be pretty alright, honestly.
On the move. On my way.
The enemy sent vehicles after us! Over!
Some of the enemies are, like, slipping by, so I'm gonna have to do something about that. Alright, this guy's doing nothing at the moment, so we're gonna put him closer.
Leader power ready.
What is going on over here? Oh, that's fine, whatever.
Restoration drones out. Spartan, moving out.
Receiving fire.
I will gladly take this mission not giving us any kinds of like base support things.
Reinforcements for you now, red team.
In exchange for not having to worry about resources at all. That's nice. Holy shit! Hey, how about he sent some ODST to disrupt the line?
We're taking out one of their warlords.
Alright, we just overkilled the hell out of the warlords.
Leader power ready.
If only I could redirect the pelicans now. Alright, looks like I can't go beyond the line. Which would be nice. It looks like they're coming from bases outside our vision. I want to take them out! Ooh, we have fucking scorpions and warthogs! Didn't realize that! Let's send these out! We'll bring a scorpion over here. Put a warthog on high ground. As well as bring my infantry up. Oh, I never upgraded this turret. Infantry!
Nightingale under fire from enemy ground troops!
So if we see any side having, like, a particularly large amount of trouble, we'll send some, forces out.
Give us something to buy.
I don't think these guys can do anything on the high ground. We're gonna swap them out then.
Sound off, Marines! Inside.
Turret upgraded.
Go easy next time, these
What's
things.
The status, Professor?
It's complicated. So many protocols. I'm probably halfway there. I need more time.
Make it fast, Professor.
We'll buy her the time, sir.
Yeah, we're gonna be fine here. We have every single direction, I'd say, pretty well fortified. And we're getting more tanks at every other second, man. Every other second. Uh-oh. Those are bad. Back fucking Nightingales up! Those are so important!
The threat has been eliminated. Assignment accepted. Orders on the score.
Where do you need me, sir?
Go easy next time. These things are
Marines under assault from enemy ground forces.
All right, we're gonna need to send some forces onto the high ground. Everybody who's not just who's not doing anything needs to head up to the high ground.
I'm getting
and help
shot
us
at
out.
By ground troops. You're still hurting. You're still breathing.
Oh, this guy's actually getting shot at. By who?
Sit back and let the drones do their weird
power. Ready.
I'm under attack from enemy infantry.
Can you stop?
Immediately. Rolling. Going.
Let's go, Helljumpers.
Fine. Have a turret.
I'm under attack.
If they're gonna be annoying at long range, whatever, right?
We're up, Leather Nation.
Send the Marines! Look at these assholes! I need snipers, is what I need, Command. Captain. Because these guys are irritating me. They're just sitting in the back going, pew 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 pew.
Another bad guy bites the dust!
Engine running!
I'm receiving fire from ground troops.
There.
On the
jerks.
Suit it up. Up there.
Oh, this is a grizzly? Oh, hell yeah. We're hijacking it.
Take over, do you? I will obliterate them.
All right. We now have...
Moving to position.
A Spartan-controlled grizzly.
Don't panic.
Covering bottom left. Bottom left will never see trouble ever.
Ready for the worst.
Ooh, hornets.
Moving to location.
Yeah, we'll put these on, too. Hornets need to help us out with any super annoyances.
Hostile spotted over.
Copy that.
Looks like we're getting some heavy trouble over here.
What is it now?
Do we have a Nightingale? I want to make sure we have a Nightingale at every single area. Yeah, okay, so far we do.
Under attack from vehicles.
Moving
over.
To location.
Whoop!
Time's a wasting, team! They want us there yesterday, team! ODST's
you get that out of here! My grizzly must not go down.
Helljumpers ready.
All right, what's going on up here? Ooh, trouble.
Understood.
Spartan 130 moving. Oh yeah.
Let's get you
fixed up. Target practice.
Is anyone going?
I'm
going to
take one of these locusts.
I'm a sitting duck.
I'm not a fan of these things just blasting away at us. There. ODSTs!
The enemy sent vehicle. Show me my targets. Double time. Up and away. Hornets buzzing.
These locusts are being pests. Oh no! My Marines! I forgot to bring them back!
Leader power ready.
Yes, yes! Yes, I agree!
Alright.
We're gonna put two Wolverines.
Ready to serve.
Who do they think they're messing with?
At every. We're gonna put two Marines. Two Wolverines north, two Wolverines south. Oh, shit, what?
Stay on target, Professor. This is what we're here for.
Isabel, what's the status of that new gunship? We need it now.
The Condor's on the way, Captain. Nothing like live combat to test a new
design. Oh, Jesus, I almost knocked something on my desk. The Condor is a UNSC super unit. Powerful Ballista Mini-Mech?
Playback time. Make it hurt, guys.
The Mini-Mech fires a highly damaging Gauss Barrage. Oh, that sounds awesome. All right, Group 3.
Marines under attack!
Squad, they need the big guns. Let's not disappoint.
Better be more than a scratch.
Here we go!
Leader power ready.
Scare versus Big Max!
We're on it, sir. We're toe-to-toe with the Scarab!
We're gonna need you to shoot the turret instead. Or, you know, whatever, it doesn't matter. While we deal with that, we need to be setting up my Kodiaks.
Copy that. Moving.
Holy shit!
How we doing?
Just finishing up. Hang on. Okay, I've done it. The ring's disarmed, and the communications relay is in place. Well, that's a little more complicated. I'm going to have to go down into the ring to set it up. I need more time.
We're
We're counting on you, Professor. Jerome, hold the control room at all costs so the Professor can get back to us when she's done. I'm not leaving anybody behind.
Copy that, sir. Game faces, team! You guys will break.
Oh yeah, we're gonna be in a very fantastic position here. Oh, I need to repair my Grizzly. We have Kodiaks covering these areas over here. I should probably move my Kodiak a little bit closer, honestly. We're gonna move it up, just in case enemies get really annoying.
Wolverine under aerial assault.
Oh, now they're sending Banshees to be annoying. No! You stop that! That's what we have the Hornets for. We have every way perfectly covered, in my opinion. And we have this Condor gunship to, like, really mess up days.
Heads up, enemy sighted.
We're being strafed by hostile bombs. Move on.
As you wish, sir.
Send in the Hornets! I think we need Wolverines.
The hostile air unit that won't leave me alone.
Look how big this thing is! It's so awesome! Okay, anyways. ODSTs, we need more forces, I guess, just here, more in the middle. Just in case. Just in case something slips by.
We've got our orders. Orders incoming, Helljumpers.
We're going in hot, crew. Buckle up. Being engaged by hostile air units.
I should probably take one of those Banshees, but we'll be fine.
Leader power ready.
I'm waiting for like three Scarabs to attack us at once. And then we can just full panic.
I'm receiving fire from air units.
Cyclops moving out.
Clear the path. Heavy load coming through.
What's broken this time?
Get yourself in order, Marines.
Under air assault.
God, how many air units are y'all gonna send after us? Jerks? Oh, whoops. Hold up. Where did these vultures come from? They're new! They're new! That's where they came from! Alright.
Show me where it hurts. There's going to be a reckoning.
Watch out, team. The Banished have sent in artillery.
No! That's bad! From where?
Vulture en route.
They're going in from here, okay.
En route.
Please do try and send the artillery and, like, land it.
Leader power ready.
I will exterminate it immediately.
Yeah.
Oh, don't die, though.
Are you people accident prone or something?
130 receiving fire from ground troops.
Okay, this doesn't seem so bad. They're sending artillery, but they're making it land right in front of us, which is the exact opposite of what you should be doing with artillery. We'll put some ODSTs down here. Fire! Yeah, okay, that was a little overkill on absolutely nothing, but whatever. Uh-oh. Yeah.
Sir, we won't be able to hold them off indefinitely.
Professor, time's running out.
Communications array is ready, Captain. You said it yourself. I can't believe until the Banished are gone. I found something down here that'll help.
Whatever it is, it better work, Professor.
Orders confirmed.
Look alive, just spotted enemy forces.
Sir.
I'm ecstatic. What do we got? Do we have another super weapon? Can we digitize them into
the enemy has made
Prometheans? You know, I'm really surprised they didn't take the opportunity to be like, and then Prometheans! Because they very much have, like, the Halo 4 and Halo 5, like, super crazy Forerunner aesthetic going on here. Everything's so fucking angular. Like, Halo, the original Halo trilogy had a little bit of this, but not as crazy. Uh-oh. Fire in the hole! Oh my god, the Wraith is just gone.
Leader power ready.
Nightingale is on the way.
We're under fire over here!
Moving.
Captain, he's back.
Put him through.
Atriox?
You think you can stand against me? I, who defied the Covenant itself.
Here's your notice, Atriox. The Ark is our home now, and it's under our protection. Cut it, Isabel. I've heard enough.
New primary objective. Hold out for 2 minutes.
You could make him any madder, but
is shit about to get real? Shit is getting real. Looks like Atriox is coming in.
All systems ready, sir.
Oh no. Are those gonna be scarabs?
We've got them on the ropes, Captain. But it's only a matter of time before they send more.
Professor, what's the plan?
I gain control of the Halo's gravity anchors, Captain. Get our troops clear and get ready.
Roger that.
I'm curious. I'm curious. But cautious. Oh yeah, here we go.
Moving. On route.
They have two scarabs. They have two scarabs! I'm gonna need to send in some forces here. Hey, how about restoration drones? And archer missiles? Oh my god, look at this thing get annihilated. It's all about the air support! Yeah, you're gonna need to send like 5 scarabs at me.
Okay to take care of this vehicle, boss.
Oh no, we lost a hero. That's okay, we can handle this.
I'm under attack!
Everyone to their stations.
Alright, let's see how everybody's doing. We're doing okay. Everyone's alive. Let's send my Nightingale over here to heal.
Under attack.
Leader power ready.
Uh-oh. This scarab's getting a little antsy, huh? Well, let's blast it out of here.
Stations are go.
That should have been a bonus objective. Kill all the scarabs before the timer's out.
Our troops are clear, Professor. Whatever you're gonna do, do it now.
I like that mission. Is she gonna disconnect a piece of land? Oh shit! Either that or she's deactivating the gravity very specifically there.
I think we've made a mistake!
Bye! They're just gone. There's nothing they can do about it. Oh my god.
Captain, it's done.
Professor Anders, we are on our way. Get to the rendezvous.
With all due respect, Spartan, I don't believe that's an option any longer.
Professor Anders, there must be some way.
Don't worry, Captain. As soon as I'm back to the Sol system, I'll get that beacon out. It should only be a few weeks.
Professor!
And then I can figure out how to get back to you.
A few weeks? Yeah, okay. I guess we'll just
Captain.
Chill here.
The other teams are clear?
Yes, sir. ETA to the Spirit of Fire is 5 minutes.
Bring up the map. We have a lot of work to do until she gets back.
Aye, Captain.
We got gold.
You honored those we lost today with your actions. I'm proud of all of you.
Take down a Scarab with Archer missiles? Oh, that was a thing? Upgrade turret deployments, upgrade your turrets to counter specific threats. Air, vehicles, infantry. Oh, you had to... I didn't make any anti-air stuff because I was just like, they're probably not going to be a big threat. And they really weren't. The Banshees didn't come in until like the last few bits of the mission. So, yeah, didn't really need to worry about that. That was pretty... That was pretty nice. I liked that. That was different rather than sieging up with... our bases and just kind of working with a tiny-ish force. We just had an entire army, like the entire ship worth of people just chilling out in the middle. We got tanks and siege units. We had a super condor unit. Oh my god, that was awesome. Okay, that was awesome, and that was apparently legitimately the last stand. What? Huh. I guess... What? Sorry, okay. When I was... I took a break, and I got back, and I looked at how many missions were left. And I knew that the last stand was, like, the last one on the list. But I was hoping that, you know, after that cutscene, it seemed like maybe we were about to do, like, one last tussle. But I guess not? I guess that's the ending of the game. Just, oh, and then... Atriox and Captain Cutter look at their maps and all their forces because they're about to commit to a long-term battle with each other. Okay. Alright. Huh. Well, I guess that's Halo Wars 2. Is there anything, like, if I skip, will anything happen? Okay, we have an after credit scene. Yeah, I bet if a Halo ring showed up in front of a planet, everyone living there would just go, oh, what shit.
Why did we drop out of slip space?
Shit. A guardian? Uh-oh. Wow, that has so many different connotations that can be taken from that. Alright, mission complete, the foundry and everything else. Halo, last stand. Cutter and his crew must fight off the brash in a final defense of Anders as she prepares the Halo voyage. And there you go. That is the entire campaign. I guess if we do missions, you can see there's only 12 missions, and the last stand was the last one of those. And apparently there's co-op in this. I could have played in co-op too. Interesting. Well, intriguing. I guess they're trying to link Halo Wars and Halo and the main Halo trilogy together. So that definitely confirms that this is after Halo, or like during the events of Halo 5 or after it. I don't know if it'll be like, it's probably before Halo 6. So what they're probably doing is, this could possibly, okay, at the end of Halo 5, slight spoilers for Halo 5 if you haven't already played it, but at the end of Halo 5, it showed a ring being controlled by Cortana. And there's a chance that maybe the ring that she's controlling is the one that we just saw brought over from the Ark. I mean, it could also be any other fucking ring, because there are tons of Halo rings just chilling out in space. There's like at least five just sitting around doing nothing and being guarded by UNSC forces. But yeah, there's a chance that they're gonna link the Halo Wars story a little bit more directly with the Halo story, which would be interesting, which would be really cool. I don't think they're gonna do anything drastic, because if they brought in this what, oh, and here's Anders in the middle of Halo 6, everyone would be like, what? Who? And if you played Halo Wars 2, then you go, oh yeah, there's Anders, what is she gonna do? And then she does like one thing in the story, and that's it or something. But I like the implication that we might get a Halo Wars 3. I think that, for my opinion of the game, Halo Wars 2 was pretty good. I really wish it didn't end off on the note that it just did. I really wish it didn't. But it handled itself very confidently. I just played Halo Wars 1 pretty much yesterday. I finished Halo Wars 1 yesterday as of me recording this. And so going into Halo Wars 2 directly, I was able to see a lot of the difference and be aware of them. And for the most part, some of the differences aren't big. A lot of my grievances from Halo Wars 1 are still here. We still have radial-based UI stuff for the bases, which is annoying, and it causes me to be very overwhelmed because I'm used to, like, not really simpler, but like more complex systems, which in turn allow you to do a lot simpler management of all your bases. Being able to go, okay, base one is on one, base two is on two, and then I press one and I press one and boom, I can make Marines, I can make Hell Jumpers, or not really Hell Jumpers, I forgot the name of the fire guys already, because I rarely use them, but you can make units from a distance without having to jump to your base. And because we weren't able to do that, I was really overwhelmed with multitasking, because it was like I had to force myself away from the fights in order to manage to make units, which is frustrating when I'm used to other games where you don't have to do that, when you can just sit there and go, all right, I'm in the middle of this fight, press one, send some more Marines, holy shit, we need more, we just lost half of them, press two, send some Scorpion tanks, all right, we're good. Or hey, press five, continue the upgrades. This game, because of its consoleized control interface, forces you to kind of nerf yourself down in terms of your overall multitasking, which is ironic, I think. I can play, I'm not like a great RTS player, I'll never claim to be good at RTS games, but I played StarCraft enough, or StarCraft 2 enough, that I was able to go, okay, I can multitask with this a little bit better. But because the system of this game is just, it goes out the window. It's like, all right, well, I am aware of these things going on, and that's it. Which is a shame. But yeah, Halo Wars 2 still has a little bit of those grievances, but it solves a lot of my other grievances from Halo Wars 1. The controls are a little bit better, not amazing so, but a little bit better. And in terms of the story, it didn't feel as jumpy as Halo Wars 1. Halo Wars 1, we went to three different planets over the course of Halo Wars 1. We started off at Harvest, then we went to Arcadia, and then we went off to the random Forerunner planet, which I don't know even if it has a name. It has a designation, but I don't know the designation. But we went to three different places, and so it didn't feel like we were committed to any real part of a story. We were just jumping from place to place to place to place. And Halo Wars 2, because all of it takes place on the Ark, which, you know, even though the Ark is a massive structure with tons and tons of different places, it might as well be multiple planets too. But because it was all focused down on the Ark and on Atriox in this plotline, it felt like it was more consistent. It felt like we had one flowing plotline that you could follow in comparison to Halo Wars 1, where sometimes it felt like there was a mission missing in between things. Not a lot, but it did feel like, oh, we just jumped to this other thing and this other thing. This one was like, oh, well, okay, we're pushing forward, we just took out this base, we're getting land, we're getting other structures, we have a plan now, we're gonna get the Halo structure running and we're gonna teleport it off. And that's nice. I'm a little sad that the Spirit of Fire didn't follow the Halo ring through that giant slip space rupture, but I guess it still lets you set up for either a Halo Wars 3 taking place in the Ark still, or other things. I think one of the parts of it is they set up that last bit to explain why the multiplayer exists, right? Because if you're doing multiplayer and you're just fighting across every little landscape, well, that's technically you in the other force. Although, it's different, since obviously it can be UNSC forces versus UNSC forces. But I liked Halo Wars 2. I think I'd have to give it a 9 out of 10 in terms of enjoyability. I really don't like the short length. I really wish it was a couple missions longer, just like with Halo Wars 1. But the difference is that I felt like it still got most of its story out of the way. It ended awkwardly, but it was still, again, it was a far smoother flowing experience, which says a lot when it's a completely different gaming development company that made this. Halo Wars 1 was made by Ensemble Studios, I believe, and this one was made by Creative Ensemble. So it's completely different studios, even though they have similar names. and they did a great job bringing this back in the fold, making it a relevant story, and it was competent, and that's great. And the best part is that it merges old Halo stuff with newer Halo stuff a little bit. It's a transitionary piece that we kind of needed when we had Halo 4 and Halo 5. Halo 4 and Halo 5 jumped the gun with a completely different art style, a whole bunch of different technology, and a whole lot of shit going on. And for a lot of people, they didn't like that. For me, I was fine with it. I could see why a lot of people didn't like it, but for me, I was fine with it. But having something like this where we go, okay, here's some old technology starting to get mixed in with the new technology, starting to get mixed in with the old and the new art style. It's great. It's like, this feels Halo. We had great music playing in a lot of the key moments, a lot of unique scenarios in the unique different missions. The fact that the last mission of the game wasn't just, here's a base, do what you've been doing for the entire game and panic and get overwhelmed. Instead, it was just, all right, you have everything at your disposal. Everything is free. We'll send you some forces. I wish we could have had some snipers so I could just place them in the towers and have a little bit of safety in mind there. But whatever, it was an awesome little last mission, even if it wasn't terribly difficult. I think if I'd been playing on Heroic or Legendary, that would have made a huge difference. But on Normal, that last mission was just like, and here's an overkill amount of units on this side, and this side, and this side. Oh, a Grizzly with a Spartan in it. Yeah, it's gonna get healed up by 3 different Nightingales. I liked the last mission, that was amusing. But yeah, that's Halo Wars 2. I enjoyed the ride quite a bit. I give it 9 out of 10. If they had slipped up a little bit more, I think I would have given it easily an 8 out of 10. Again, I don't like the short link. They didn't solve a lot of my grievances with Halo Wars 1 in terms of, again, unit control and the UI, but they did a little bit of a better job. The units handled a little bit better. The UI was a little bit better to access versus Halo Wars 1, which was basically just a remaster thrown onto the PC. And so it's like, all right. But yeah, all right, that's it. People are gonna ask if I'm gonna play the multiplayer. I don't know. I just don't know. So I will see. Maybe I'll play some rounds, especially, you know, if I can join up with friends and we can do some just like maybe co-op against AI or just see what happens in multiplayer. But for now, that's the campaign. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. Sucks that it was a little bit on the shorter side than I expected. I was really hoping this was going to be kind of like a 10 or 12 hour experience, but instead it was, from what I can see, more like 6 to 7 hours on normal difficulty, which is a little bit short. Really, really, really short. But if you like the multiplayer, then there's that. And there's obviously also Blitz, which I don't even like know anything about, and I've heard some good things about that too. So hey, look at that. Is that the... All right. That's the Mjolnir 6 armor, I think? Except with a Halo Wars art style instead. That's different. Okay, well, anyways, yep, that was Halo Wars 2. I think in terms of... One thing I'm surprised they didn't touch on, they didn't touch at all on the in-between story that I mentioned at the beginning of the game. That makes me a little sad. I know they kind of just dropped Serena really quickly. I would have liked to have at least seen a cutscene involving the flood infection that happened on the ship in the 28 years that it was drifting. I would have liked to see a little bit of that, especially since it would have had some in-game character development for Jerome. Even having it as like an in-game mission as a tutorial to teach you how to use soldiers, that would have been a good start too. But oh well. And speaking of cutscenes, just as another random aside, they did a lot of... I feel like there were significantly less cutscenes in this game than Halo Wars 1, which is a little bit on the disappointing side. There were a lot of missions that ended, and then you just went to the next mission. In Halo Wars 1, every mission ended with like a fucking rendered cutscene and shit happening. This one was a little bit more liberal with its background, but in exchange, some of those rendered cutscenes were pretty awesome. I think, absolutely, the cutscene where Isabel destroys Atriox's ship was pretty damn impressive. And also, Departures was pretty good too. Anders flinging all of Atriox's forces into space. And then just that's it. They're just dead. I really enjoyed that moment. That was a creative use of everything. But alright. Thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this Let's Play. I will see you guys later.